Hello everyone, how are you guys doing today? My name is Cyrus and welcome to my channel. Today I'm doing another video for Bob Saget, telling a story about Rodney Dangerfield. So without any delays, let's get to it. Here we go.
But you do stand up and it's a really nice thing to do because you get to make people laugh. And we really need to laugh right now because there's so much crazy shit going on. And when, even at that time, when I was starting out, I knew that there was like a light at the end of the tunnel, and I got to meet a lot of comedians. I became friends with Rodney Dangerfield, who was someone that helped my career. And so you know him, because he's funny as shit. And
yeah.
And when I met him, he had just come out of a spa, and he was trying to clean up a little bit, because he had some habits. So he was proud of them. He loved pot. He said, I'm telling everybody about pot, man. I'm gonna smoke it the rest of my life. And I was actually in a hospital room with him the night before he had a surgical procedure, and he was smoking pot. And I said, Rod, you gotta stop. It's kind of dangerous right now. He said, what are you talking about, man? I don't care. I said, no, there's an oxygen tank next to you, Rodney. We're all gonna die. So Rodney, when I first meet him, I'm in a comedy club in San Diego, and he comes in, I don't know him. And he goes, man, I don't know how I'm doing it. I'm supposed to be in a spa, and I'm doing no coke, no booze, no pot, no pills. And I'm like, this guy's fascinating. He said, I've seen you on TV, man. You're funny, man. You got a Jew head. You know what that means? You're fucked. You're fucked. You can't stop kicking. You're doing jokes all day long. You're fucked. And I'm like, I got a new friend. And so I knew him my whole career. And I actually officiated his funeral. And I had a pretty good set. And he had two beautiful kids, still does, and his widow gave me a lovely gift, and this is a true story. She gave me a box that said RD on it, and I open it up, and there's a pot pipe in there, and that's his pot pipe. And then I look further into this little box. This is a true story, you're not gonna believe it. There's a bottle of Viagra, and it says Rodney Dangerfield Viagra. That's a $2 million eBay item right there. And there was one pill in it that was 10 years old. People, don't take a 10-year-old Viagra. I'm telling you right now. Has anybody ever taken Viagra here? Someone said yes on television. Most people would never say a word because
nice
they're
shit.
With someone that they have sex with and they go, yes, I take Viagra. They go, what the fuck? I thought those were real erections. No, honey, I use a pipe cleaner and duct tape to make a dog laugh. Sir, you have taken Viagra? Where are you? Raise your hand, sir. Raise your penis. And what is your name, sir? What is your name? Jack? That makes sense. Why? Jack, what was the occasion for the Viagra? Was it a special occasion? Was it a birthday? You can't last. This is amazing. We're on television. This is fucking awesome. Jack, you're sitting here like a jury in the OJ trial right now. You're telling a room full of people that you just can't last. That's just, and you got a little Jake Gyllenhaal in you. You got it going. Is that how you say his name? Gyllenhaal? Gyllenhaal? Is it Gyllenhaal?
He's talking about Jake Gyllenhaal.
No matter. He can't get a hard on. Who gives a fuck what Jake's name is? You're a good-looking guy. You can't last. You take him right, though. You take him orally. Don't put them in the pee hole. Because I call it a pee hole, by the way. It's going to be in my TED Talk. I know it's called a urethra, but she's my favorite singer, and she's retiring. So well, here's a story that happened to me. I had never taken a Viagra before, and so I had a bottle that said Rodney Dangerfield Viagra with a 10-year-old pill in it, and I was in between relationships, and I was in a bar. This happened about 8 years ago, I guess, and this girl says to me, come on, let's go to your house. Let's hang. And that's what, you know, a millennial says to an older man. Let's hang. All he does is hang. He can't get it up. What can I do? I feel
that's
so
bad brilliant.
For you right now. I feel worse for your wiener. Wiener. TED Talk. So I don't know what to do. We're in the den, we're hanging out, and I needed to do something because little Bob wasn't feeling it. He looked at me like Shemp Howard from the Three Stooges. He was just going, meep, 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 making noise. You don't need to know the reference or nothing. Just know that's the sound my dick made. So I run upstairs and I open a drawer and I find the Rodney Dangerfield 10-year-old Viagra, and like a moron, I took it. Don't do shit like that. I go downstairs, an hour goes by. I don't get an erection, but my eyes started to bulge out of my head. And I started to talk like, I got no dick, no dick at all. I'm gonna put a bag over my dick in case your bag breaks. So nothing happened. And But years went by, and now that I'm 60, I went, you know, I should have a supply, I think. I mean, you're supposed to, like, when you're older, if you want to perform, and I love performing. So I go to get a prescription of Viagra filled. This is a totally true story. It happened in my neighborhood, so you know it's the truth. And I go into the drugstore, and that's all I went in there to pick up. But then I see a little bottle of travel hairspray, and I bought that because I like to look nice for the people. And I put for the people. So I put the travel hairspray right on the pharmacy counter. And then I said, I'd like my prescription, please. And she puts the Viagra on the counter, and then she was cool about it. She didn't yell it out like you see in comedy movies that rip off Woody Allen. And she said to me, okay, with the copay, your prescription is $1,200. $1,200 for Viagra. And I went, no. I had righteous indignation. No, no. I'm just gonna use the hairspray. Thank you very much. I didn't realize that came out weird or what she thought, but she's like staring at me, creep the fuck out. She's thinking that what I'm saying is that instead of Viagra, I'm just going to take travel hairspray and just do that. Just freaking get that thing all just clean the cube. Just shellac that fucker. Get a Build-A-Bear hat, put it on the end of it.
Oh, that's so good.
So I didn't get it. And I just now I met somebody that I don't want to talk about because I would never talk about my problems like you in public.
So that was Bob Saget telling a story about Rodney Dangerfield, and what an absolute brilliant bit. I really, really enjoyed that, and I'm so much looking forward to doing more Bob Saget. And the fact that guy spoke in the audience and said he takes or took Viagra, also that he can't last long, and that was just so fucking ridiculously stupid thing to do, especially in front of a comedian. Do not reveal your secrets to the fucking comedian. They will bury you. They will destroy you. You know what I mean? And he did absolutely that. He destroyed that kid, man. He destroyed his self-esteem. Well, no kid, he's man, because I think he's probably my age. But still, man, the whole bit, absolute brilliant. And taking an expired Viagra pill and getting that sort of a reaction, I'm not surprised about that. And the whole hairspray and Viagra misunderstanding between a chemist and him was absolute genius stroke of comedy gold. And the story was absolutely brilliant. I really enjoyed that, and I hope you did too. If you did, like, subscribe, share, and leave a comment. Also, follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Links are in the description down below. And I'll see you guys next time.